As long as Trump is in power, the U.S. will never be a safe country for asylum seekers. Will the Prime Minister show the moral leadership by suspending the Safe Third Country Agreement?
Member of Parliament from Vancouver East, Jenny Kwan, has been calling on Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau to suspend the Safe Third Country Agreement for more than a year now, following the U.S. travel ban against certain Muslim countries in January 2017. She says the recent controversy on the separation of children from parents at the U.S. immigration border shows why it should have been done immediately.
Really reaffirmed the notion that the United States is no longer a safe country, even though Trump has now backtracked on taking the children away from the parents. Still, their policies are not safe for asylum seekers.
The Safe Third Country Agreement is a treaty between the two countries to manage the flow of refugee claimants at the shared land border. Simply put, with both the U.S. and Canada considered as safe havens, refugee seekers can only claim asylum on where they first arrive. While Trudeau asserts that what the U.S. has been doing is wrong, he isn't quick to change his mind on the agreement.
I cannot imagine what these families are going through. As I've said many times, the Safe Third Country Agreement is over 10 years old, and we will continually look for ways to modernize it and be in conversation with the Americans on this. And we will continue as well to closely monitor developments in the United States.
Kwan, however, believes that if Canada does not step up, the country adds to the problem.
Why are we forcing people to risk life and limb to get to safety? And then in addition to the risks for the asylum seekers themselves, we're also creating a huge challenge for border communities. And that, to me, is wrong. And we need our Canadian government, we need the Prime Minister, to step up and to take action.
Kwan has sponsored e-petition 1755 at the House of Commons for the immediate suspension of the Third Safe Country Agreement. It lists, among others, the U.S. Muslim travel ban, recent separation of children from their parents, and the zero-tolerance policy in irregular border crossings as reasons for the petition. Petition E-1755 is open for signature to all Canadian residents and citizens until October 20 this year. Marieton Pacheco, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.